Leck and Greg Vegan Camp, the 1st of July 2022.
I need Ben, my parrot friend, maybe the same like last time, but landed on my hand and now it's on my shoulder. The parrot, I'm the parrot man.
This is just fun because tomato plants are just popping up and there's a pineapple growing here, then the tomato plant, and the tomato is supported by the pineapple. It's just lovely. Lime season is really upon us. You just see, you can just go every day and pick up limes from the ground like apples in Europe. It's just crazy. Wow. Oh, this is maybe old now. Welcome to Lime. Everywhere. When it's rain season, it's also season for these bamboo shoots. Very delicious, steamed or boiled. The first sawarot are dropping. Sawarot is passion fruit, another one here. And we can see the passion fruit dome. Roses, a couple of roses. Otherwise, in Likaset Farm, it also has some action of drying some banana products, bananas mixed with berries and stuff like that. And also there's going on with some drying of chaya. Lung is doing some stuff in the garden and has made this beautiful thing here with wood, standard wood, like hardwood and bamboo. This is like a xiangda, I think, and it's like a herb and a vegetable at the same time, and this is like Thai people enjoy it for different healing purposes, health purposes. Yesterday Fabian helped me to clear these branches so cars can drive here through, because branches were going into the road here. So that has been done also this month. And we still have mangoes on some trees, so it's pretty interesting. I almost forgot about these mangoes. The neighbor has planted corn, not for humans, but for animals. A cash crop here in Thailand. People are growing corn for like animal feed, or they're growing the cassava. Or for the cassava flower. And here we have the fence to Leck and Greg Vegan Camp, and the entrance is still here. The top part is gone now because it started to fall apart, which is nice because if we have a truck that needs to go in with some materials, it can go through now. This month we also harvested some pineapples, which are really nice. Pineapples are nice, but we just have so few, but it's just so special when you grow your own pineapple and you can just take it from the garden, take off the top, plant the top, and eat the pineapple, of course. It's just, wow, just amazing. And the cool thing about pineapples is that you can pick them almost when they are completely yellow-orangey, but the top still is a little bit green. So what you do is flip them around and just keep them for a day or two, just to even out the distribute the sugars in the pineapple, and also make the pineapple not more sweet but less sour in the top of the pineapple, because the sweetness of course is at the bottom of the pineapple always. So let's say you want to share a pineapple with somebody and people say, okay, which part do you want, and they cut it like the top and bottom, you always pick the bottom unless it's rotten completely. And otherwise, how you share it, you'll cut it like when the pineapple is standing, you just cut it like from the top in like four quarters if you're four people, or half if you want to share it with somebody else, just half from center top, and then you share the two halves like that instead, which is much more fair. And it's all about fairness, easy life and niceness. That's what we're we're talking about all the time. Some old wood we are preserving so it's not being burnt, and Fabian is making a structure to keep it off the ground, which is so cool. I don't remember if I talked about the red Cavendish, but the big red Cavendish over here already gave fruit. It's just nice to get a different type of banana. Even I eat the Gouaynamois, the apple bananas every day. It's just nice to get something else sometimes. And it's really delicious. And if we have like a rack, giant rack like that, we cannot eat it. So it's frozen. We have a couple of boxes of frozen Gluai Homdang, the red Cavendish, which is really nice. Here's the pineapple that was harvested from here, and I'm not sure, but I think this will just fall off and then it will grow a new one. Let me know in the comments below if you know about pineapples growing another one. If they already give fruit, will they give another one at some point or not? But otherwise it's just nice to break them off and just plant them. All the pineapples here are grown that way. I don't know if there's any other way to do it. Here are some cassava. We dug some up. They're just delicious cassava. Steam cassava is just fresh steam cassava, delicious of this type. There are different types. But then what you do is just replant a couple of new ones. But it's just good to take them out once in a while, so they can grow new roots, because the old roots are inedible because they're just too big and too hard to eat. I mean, you can eat them in an emergency situation, but otherwise they just grow too fall. It's just a little bit of a mess growing into the mango trees. But otherwise, yeah, it's a little bit wild and nice. So here's a really interesting thing. When we try to grow the winter squash around here, it doesn't really grow in the middle of the row, but later I'll just show you how they're growing inside a compost area. Here, managing the border so the neighbors won't spray. So all the borders, we are like cutting the weeds. So there's limiting the amount of chemicals going into the vegan camp. Chaya is just so beautiful. It just grows like a single thing and just explodes with food. All this, like most of this, is like the young shoots. They're edible and it's just like delicious. And bananas just popping up everywhere, as always. The beans are having a party all around. Another bean patch, and these will just invade the garden in a couple of months. It will be a bean invasion. Similar to ant invasion, if you have any tips on how to manage black ants, these that are very persistent black ants here in Thailand, in an organic and vegan way, then please let me know in the comments below. Thank you very much. These beans are even more developed. You can see already they're like invading the garden, and that's why we're trying to trim the grass as much as possible, because it's really difficult to manage the weeds when there are beans all over the place at the same time. You can see these patches are just like, they're like, don't look healthy at all compared to the pumpkin winter squash growing around here. You know, it's just completely different story. Also hard to manage anything. The weeds are just growing in between, and that makes it a little bit hard to spot the pumpkins. For example, we have a pumpkin here, and sometimes it's good to. Because if you don't spot the pumpkin when it's ripe, ready to, then it will just spoil, which is not the coolest thing, because we want to eat the pumpkins. I mean, there are quite some here, over there, and I don't know how many million of them inside. Can you spot the pumpkin around here? Let's see who will spot it first, you or me. Okay, let's go here and just take out some weed. I remember where it is. It's just like a. Oh, yeah, I see it now. Do you see it? I don't think, because the camera. See? Here it is. I think this is the biggest, most mature one we have. It was hanging on this mango tree, but it fell down, apparently. Oh, maybe it broke. Maybe it broke this branch or not. I'm not sure. Who knows? And yeah, I mean, before I could go around this banana plant, this red Cavendish, but now it's impossible to get inside without boots, rubber boots. You never know what's lurking inside. Maybe a Yeti. This is one of the innovations, latest innovations, a tent, which is just much more easy to manage, clean and set up, and we can just pack it down and put it in a box, compared to bamboo structures that need to be maintained. So when there's not a lot of visitors, it's just easier to set something up like this whenever needed. And it's just huge, it's like 5 meters in diameter. So it's just much bigger than the structures we have anyway. And canvas tent is pretty nice because it's very breathable. So there's like a lot of air circulation. This might be the future of the vegan camp, just by these types of tents. Or we will need to have tents that are more waterproof, because canvas cotton tents are not as waterproof as normal tents, nylon tents and stuff like that, because it's just a different material. But nylon tents are not as much as breathable as these, so it's plus and minus stuff with these things. And of course we have the Longans coming up, which will, the high season is end of July, end of this month, and whole August. So it's really nice. These are like very nice to eat for breakfast or all day long. So Fabian here is still here. It's a mystery why he's still here. He's still learning a lot of Thai. If you know somebody who also knows Thai that wants to come by and volunteer together with Fabian, Puying. Puying, are you alright? If you want to explore the vegan lifestyle and volunteer, it's a good place to be, I think.
Got it.
And also at the same time learn Thai. I mean, it has helped me a lot that Fabian is here to regarding my Thai also. He has a question.
Tell Tom, say goodbye. Sawadee krap kon. Or say hello. Makrutlime.
Also makrut lime, very nice for all kinds of things, for washing, and like this is very good for doing the dishes if there's a little bit of oil somewhere. A little bit accident oil.